Welcome to prefabricated structures module 2 with the remaining part. Wall panels. The wall panels are used or casted with all fixings like doors, ventilation, window frames. The wall panels are non-load bearing walls. Therefore, these neglect solid rectangular cross-section wall panel with RCC from the view of thermal effects and safety. The minimum of 150 mm is provided as the wall thickness. Here we consider the minimum thickness of wall to be as 150 mm for the prefabricated structures. This wall is a sandwich type wall, wherein external and internal surfaces are of same material and internal core surface will be of different material. So the different material can be as the particular foam or a particular type of other absorbent material, wherein this makes a wall as the sound isolation proof as well as thermal insulation proof. Both type of properties can be achieved by the sandwich type of prefabricated wall. That is a cellular concrete blocks of 75 mm thick is sandwiched by RCC M25 grade of concrete to a thickness of 37.5 mm on either face with a minimum reinforcement. Since the walls are in steel molds, there will be no used to plastering on either face of wall, as the walls, when they are casted, they are having the steel formwork. Steel formwork, we call them as steel molds. So these steel molds will be providing us the surface of the RCC wall as a smooth surface, wherein no requirement of internal and external plastering for the particular wall surface. It is clearly finished surface is available at the time of casting itself. This is one of the advantage of precast panel walls. The main design factor is the handling stresses in wall panels. The infillings wall may be any lightweight material, low cost material like brick bats, brick, lightweight concrete, equintained concrete, etc., or aerated concrete like that. Since the preparation and availability of raw materials are easily in the case of cellular concrete, we are able to adopt a cellular concrete as an infills in the walls. So same as the cellular concrete is going to be used as the infill walls. So these walls are prepared with RCC material and cellular concrete blocks. What a wall must be having? It should be withstand without harmful deformations the loads that it is required to carry, permit or absorb the movements due to temperature variations and differences without sustaining damages, have a good architectural effect, be resistant to climatic influences, require the least possible maintenance, provide the requisite acoustics, insulation and offer fire protection even though there is a two types of materials, there will be some amount of fire catching property in the material. If we use a material as a wood, it will obviously catch a fire. Fulfill the other basic requirements of prefabrication constructions. So, wall panel, whenever we try to consider, that time we need to understand the things that there should not be any harmful deformations, there should not be any temperature variations beyond the permittable or absorbable movements, and without any sustainable damages. Need to have a good architectural effect. Must also resistance to climatic influences. Require the least possible maintenance. Then, moving further, according to performance of and the function of external wall panels are the following kinds: load bearing, stiffening, which we call them as wind bracings, Merle space enclosing called as partition walls or curtain walls. The class design of a wall panels depends on the requirements. Single layer solid panels consisting of one material, that is lightweight concrete. Multi-layer panels consisting of concrete and insulating materials. Special section slabs, which may be either of single layer or multi-layer constructions. Sandwich type of constructions will be there. Structure for exterior wall. Exterior wall consists of a panel one or two story height and one or two rooms in width. The panel may be blind without openings or with window or door openings. Blind, when we say there is no opening, and if there are door and window openings, then we can say it as non-blind type. Design, wall panels may be single layer, solid part, multi-layer, sandwich type. Solid panels are manufactured from materials that have insulating properties and at the same time can perform supporting functions, for example lightweight concrete, cellular concrete and hollow ceramic stones are used. Sandwich wall panels are made with two or three layers. Their thickness depends on the climate conditions to the regions and physiotechnical properties of the materials used for the insulating layer and for the exterior layer. The surface of exterior wall panel is covered with decorative mortar, so we are able to have a architectural look and decorative look as a small part of designs can also be utilized into the molds or is faced with a ceramic or the other finishing tiles are placed. After assembly, the joints between panel are filled with mortar or with lightweight or ordinary concrete and then sealed with packing and special mastics. Structure of interior walls. A large panel structure of interior walls may be non-load bearing or load bearing. In the first case, they are made from gypsum slag concrete or from other materials that acts as enclosures. In the case of load-bearing structure, the wall panels which combine enclosing and load-bearing function are made from the heavy or lightweight silicate or cellular concrete or vibration set brick or ceramic work. The dimensions of the panels are determined by the dimensions of the rooms. In apartment houses, their height is equal to the height of a story. The width is equal to the depth or the width of a room. And the thickness of the wall is between the rooms is usually for 10 to 14 centimeter. In apartment, 14 to 18 centimeters. This method allows the highest degree of mechanism of production is to cast the wall panels in the upright battery forms. Because of smoothness of the form walls, such panels do not to be rendered. In addition, the extra reinforcement normally provided to resist the stresses set up when finalizing or lifting panels can be in horizontal forms becomes a superfluous. These are the interior walls wherein we can achieve the economy of the construction and manufacturing of prefabricated walls. The classic panel wall is a room-sized panel. A room-sized panel means we can say this as one single panel with a room size of width. If a door opening occurs in the wall, there are three possible variations. So these are the three possible variations. We can see first two types. The opening is in the center of the panel. So this we are able to see opening. With the opening situated at the one side, the distance between the door has the edge of the panel is sometimes narrow that a column member is provided. B. The lintel part of the panel is designed as a cantilever shape of the shape panel is then reasonably simple, but carpentry work around the door is more difficult. This is one of the internal load bearing wall panel acting a girder wall. So we can see this as the total part of height and the total width, how much is the room size, and this is the total reinforced wall. Provision of door opening is also provided. Depending on the orientation of main beams or load bearing walls relative to long axis of the building, prefabricated wall systems are classified as long walls system, cross wall system, ring or two-way system. Long wall system. Main beam or load bearing walls are placed parallel to the long axis of buildings. It is applied to the building with a large prefabrications and is similar to the traditional brickwork technique. Longitudinal external walls which carry a floor loads must possesses not only thermal properties but also sufficient load carrying. The long wall system construction is a typical with large blocked structure and special pier blocks between the windows which carry loads from lintel and the wall above. The horizontal steel blocks are not loaded with the particular loadings. Long wall system, cross wall system. So long wall system, if we consider the long wall system, in some design space between the pier is filled by prefabricated unit consisting of reinforced concrete window, that is RC window frame, complete with window. Internal wall blocks are normally of full story height. subjected to limitations imposed by lifting equipments available. Both internal and external walls are made of same materials. Crosswall system. Crosswall system, load-bearing walls and beams are placed at a right angles perpendicular to each other to the longitudinal axis of the building. In this system, the floor units are provided with two-way structural units which distribute the to the cross walls, and this system is more prominent. The internal walls are made of ordinary concrete or load-bearing walls, and the external walls are made up of lightweight concrete to reduce the dead load of the structure. We call them it as the weight of the structure. Ring system. Load-bearing walls and beams are placed in both ways, longitudinal and transversely. They are used in building with a ring system of support. Floor are normally supported on all the floor edges and span in two directions. They span in vertical direction as well as they span in horizontal direction. Skeleton construction, these floors are placed directly on the columns. In this system, the floor slabs are designed to span in both directions and are loaded on the supporting walls. Supporting walls will be at the ends. For large load panels, cross beams are hidden with the thickness of the panel. So this was about the ring system, wherein it is also in the perpendicular directions, both in longitudinal and transverse. Also support for a normally supported on the four edges of the particular room walls, or sometimes they are directly supported on the columns. Column provisions will be provided for the support at the corners or at intermediate parts. There they will be supporting in this manner. Thank you. See you in the next video.